When the original prairies were plowed and planted to agricultural crops, farming practices took a toll on the land. The long drought in the 1930s, combined with a cycle of plowing, tilling, and planting, caused the productive prairie soils to turn to dust and blow away. The area affected by this agricultural devastation became known as the Dust Bowl and encompassed the southern plain states of Colorado, Kansas, New Mexico, Oklahoma, and Texas. Other parts of the country, such as the bluff country of the upper Mississippi River watershed, witnessed floods and extreme erosion. People began to understand the importance of protecting our soil and water. These conditions created the setting for the conservation program still in place today. Unless we plan and create systems to manage water flow and reduce erosion, this extreme degradation of the environment can happen again. Soil is lost and nutrients depleted, making farming unsustainable. With global climate change, temperature and precipitation extremes are becoming more common. There are many different ways to control soil erosion. Today, we will discuss the key line method, which is a variation of a terrace. The key line is a form of terrace that retains water on the land. The key line system uses terraces, but of a different type and in a different way than conventional terracing systems. Terraces reduce soil erosion and move water away. A conventional terrace is a berm or ridge and channel that's built across the slope of a field. The purpose of a terrace is to reduce soil erosion by reducing the length of the slope and retain runoff to conserve water. A key line system incorporates the same idea as a terrace and adds catch basins and a specific type of contour cultivation. It's a whole farm water management system that works with the topography of the land. A key line system is typically used in areas that have severe drought or areas with heavy rains. The key line system integrates terraces, basins, and cultivation techniques with the topography of the farm. It's a farm planning system that incorporates berms, swales, and basins that work with the topography to keep water on the land, reduce soil erosion, and build soil fertility. It was developed by Percival Yeomans in Australia in the 1940s. Elements of the key line system are the key point, key line, berms, catch basins, and the use of the subsoiler plow. The key point is the point where the valley first begins to flatten out. Some people think of a slope visually as similar to an arm, with a shoulder, bicep, elbow, and wrist, with the key point at the wrist. The convex slope above is where the erosion occurs. The concave slope below is where soil is deposited. This compares to terminology used by the Natural Resources Conservation Service, NRCS, in their soil loss equation, also known as the software program Russell II. Some farms have a key point higher up, as on the shoulder, or lower down on the wrist. What is the key line? It runs through the key point on a contour with the valley. Catch basins are small depressions of less than 1 acre, which are located high up at each end of the key line. During extreme rains, these basins temporarily hold water and let it soak into the soil. In the key line system, the farmer creates berms along several key lines. This spreads the runoff evenly across the valley. The farmer cultivates in a pattern parallel to the key lines above and below them. This creates an effect of amplified contour lines. The final element of the key line water management system is the practice of using a subsoiler to make deep, narrow channels that help water and air infiltrate down. This helps roots and soil microorganisms thrive. Let's visit a couple farms in Viola, Wisconsin to look at the key line water management system. So here we are in Viola, Wisconsin. I'm with Mark Shepherd of Forest Agriculture Enterprises. Hi, Mark.
Hello.
And Mark is consulting with a local farmer who's just getting started on agroforestry cropping systems. Mark, do you want to tell us what you're doing here?
Sure. The first thing that we do on any new agroforestry system is we attempt to optimize the land's relationship with the water, with the rainfall patterns. And on this property here, The soil in the site itself is perfect for a key line swale system. And what we've done is we've used a laser level, and we've laid out a series of key line swales, which is a shallow ditch with a soft downhill contour mound. And on any slope, there's three different inflection points that will be where your key lines are, and at the shoulder, at the elbow, and at the wrist is where you can do the least amount of earthwork to impact the maximum amount of downslope land, the water relationships. So this particular swale system is right on the shoulder. Yeah. And it's designed to capture the water, spread it out from the valley, and move it around to the ridge at a very gentle 1% downhill slope. And then as it curves the ridge, it's perfectly level, so the water can fill it up, slowly drain through the soft downhill berm, and spread across the landscape.
So we're standing right on one of the key lines?
We are standing at the top key line swale itself.
Like the shoulder?
Right up at the shoulder, correct. And our goal is to slow the water down, give it an opportunity to soak in, to drain through rodent holes, and as it does, it will infiltrate the groundwater and it'll water the trees. When we come here to plant trees in the spring, the trees will be planted just on the downhill side of the soft contour mound.
And there's grain in this bucket.
I have here a bucket of winter rye that I'm going to scatter across this because we want to get lots of roots in over the winter time to hold it in place come next spring. So that's what I'm going to do now.
We just took a look at a new installation of a key line water management system. And what's really neat is now we can look at what that might look like 15 years down the road. Here we are with Mark again on his farm. And can you show us, Mark, some of the structure so that we can visualize better what we saw from the installation process, where that is now here on your place?
Down behind you, this little round pocket in there, that's
that
a little pocket pond. Yep, that was where that post with the white ribbon on it was. That was a key point right here in the landscape. And then the key line swale goes diagonally in that direction, just uphill from the hybrid poplar trees, which are the real tall, straight
tall
trees
ones
that we see. The previous property that we saw is an alley cropping system. He's alley cropping hay, and he's going to be growing chestnuts just like we are. Up behind us, we see some of this bright yellowish green. That's asparagus. So the pattern goes an alley of asparagus, a swale, a berm, the tree, which in this case is chestnuts, an alley of asparagus, a swale, a berm, the tree, the roadway, swale, berm, tree, and the pattern repeats itself over the whole entire property.
Which did you plant first? Which crop?
The trees that we planted first are the ones that took the longest to mature. In this case would be the chestnut trees. That would have been done the spring following the time when we installed the swales and the berms. First we alley cropped with squash, with zucchini and winter squash and pumpkins. Then we planted the asparagus a couple years into the program.
So it's pretty flexible. As time and budget permit, you can plant the crop that you're able to plant at that in that
sure.
year.
Sure, if I had it my way, I would have planted everything all at once, but I didn't have the dollars to do that. And so we alley cropped for a number of years. And you can do it consecutively through the years, adding a new woody crop as you go, and transitioning from hay or produce to asparagus, or even to grazing, turn it into a silvopasture system.
And from a water management perspective, I know you've had some really heavy floods here in this area. How did this land respond to those floods?
Well, we are high up in the landscape, and so we obviously wouldn't get covered with water. But we had our fair share of it. One rain event was 10 inches of rain in 1 hour that was recorded at the Viroqua Airport. And the whole surrounding countryside was seriously flooded. All of the fields surrounding our farm had raging rivers that came through culverts onto our farm. But this whole area here, there was no overland water flow. The water hit the ground, was intercepted by all the different swales and berms and pocket ponds, and was spread out and had enough time to soak in through rodent holes and following root channels.
So you're really helping out the neighbors too.
And yeah, right, and hoping to prevent floods down in New Orleans.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Mark, for showing us aspects of the key line water management system. It's been really great.
You're welcome.